Okay, let's see. I think I have to adjust it like that. Hi, I'm Rain Dog. Brief history. I've been publishing poetry for about 26 years. I recently had to retire from that, and I'm trying to reestablish myself as a poet here in Long Beach. So I'm going to read a couple of poems from this book, Fire and Rain, Volume 2. First, one of the first books I published. Okay. This poem is called City No Escape. I'm so tired of living here alone in this sprawl of lights and concrete and sweat, of placing one foot in front of the other, huffing my way around this concrete racetrack with one eye on the carrot and the other looking over my shoulder, waiting for the man to slap me on the back and say, come on now, we got your sorry ass. Living on dreams, working all the angles, getting love whenever or however, not just from sex, but from a smile or a way the light bounces off a car window on the street, or from the smell of midnight blooming jasmine, from a song on the radio while you know you're driving your life sideways away from the current dream that keeps you moving along. And you know that in that moment, you can say, that the song can say love more than deeply than all the late night kisses and penetrating looks your lover might give you. And you can only appreciate and savor that moment alone because you are alone mostly, and you and your ride, a clean window and light traffic, the music sometimes beautiful, sometimes ugly beyond belief, but always there, even when the radio is silent, always there in the stillness of that moment, in the presence of the cityscape that rolls past you like a silent movie with a separate soundtrack of whoosh and roar, of song and chatter, of honk and sirens wail and tires hum and whine, and you watch it day in and day out from the safety of your head, from the theater of one. What is it that keeps us in this particular groove? What forces keep us from jumping right out and sliding into another like some miraculous recovery? There is a longing, a gnawing in the gut, an aching in the soul that is always present, always your companion, like an old injury that never healed right, or an unpaid debt, or a piece of karmic grit that may or may not become a pearl of wisdom, a knowledge that something ain't right. You hear and you sense it, but mostly you ignore it, block it out, this feeling of incompletion, as if it could be buried beneath the daily input, the daily ration of numbness, another course of bricks, another coat of paint, another hour of the silent movie in the theater of one, another moment rolling past where you look out and in the absence of a star, look instead at the lights on Echo Park Lake and make a wish for a theater of two, for someone to share the theater, the silent movie, for someone to confirm, to bear witness to the silent movie, to the magical play of light and sound and the wonder and horror of it all. Left foot, right foot. Pages are stuck together. I hate that. Yeah. Step, step, stepping. Huff, huff, huffing. Roll, roll, rolling. Right foot, left foot, keep moving, don't stop now. Where's that carrot? Who's that behind me? Left foot, right foot, going, going, gone. So, that's one. Oh, thank you. And this other one I wrote October 27th, 1996, 98, 97, 98, yeah. on the birth date of Charlie Parker. And, okay, here we go. It's what I call a jazz poem, but it may not be an actual jazz poem, but I'm self-taught, so forgive me. Yardbird burned. Yardbird burned, all wick, no candle. Made it to the sun and back, unlike Icarus. Yardbird couldn't burn out. His spirit was the flame by which he burned. Yardbird burned till there was only a husk left, till all the notes, the bebop and bitty black notes, were piled at his feet like cigar ash. Yardbird swung his sax in a mighty arc like an axe, spinning like a dervish, carving a niche out of the don't take it for granted walls of swing jazz tradition. Yardbird shaped a bop cigar sarcophagus out of his brief time on this planet. The bop line firing volley after volley of bitty black notes skyward, unleashing them like blackbirds, blotting out reality's harsh light to the wee wee hours. Yardbird was never at ease, never at rest. Fingers were always a blur, accelerating, 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 and then time shifted gears in self-defense into slow motion, then to stand still. Yardbird smiled, because only he saw the joke. Yardbird burned. Did not really play his sax. It played him until his reed fell apart, broke down, disintegrated, broke Bird down. Time finished him with a smile on his face, death by cosmic relief. You say it was H that took his life, but you are wrong. H lulled Mr. Charlie into slowing down, hypno enticed him, slowed him down, promised him the means to survive this heartbreak we call life. H slowed the bird down, gave time a clean shot. Time took it from there. Yardbird burns still. Thank you.